Stay a little longer.
Sorry, babe, but I really gotta go.
I'll make some coffee.
Okay, I'll grab a shower, get dressed, and then I'm out of here.
Hey, you're a good-looking guy, you know that? Statuette of Sox, one of the characters in my favorite video game. It's broad daylight outside. I think I'm a little early. Collection of Motown albums. I wouldn't swap them for CDs for all the gold in the world. Oh, Sam looks like she's sulking. And I know what's bothering her. Go back to bed, Sam. You're gonna catch a death of cold like that.
I'm not cold.
Oh, look, Sam, please don't start. I got no intention of dying today.
I'm sick of living in fear like this. Every morning, I'm terrified that something's gonna happen to you.
I know how you feel, Sam. You just need some time, that's all. I'd like to see you like this. You know that, baby.
Well, what if you quit? We could move to Florida and take over my parents' store. We'd have a normal life. We could have a baby.
I'm just not made for that kind of life, Sam. I've been around too much violence all my life to go live some kind of normal life like that. I know you love me, babe. So try to understand me, too.
I love you, Tyler.
Hi, Tyler. Oh, Carl is looking for you.
Yeah, I know. So, you ready for retirement, man?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
New, Tyler.
Hi, Tyler.
Hey, Tyler, what do you know? Just the guy I was looking for. You remember that $100 I loaned you about 6 months ago? I'd really like for you to get that back to me as soon as possible. Like maybe now, for example?
Jeffrey, do you believe in our Lord Jesus Christ? Because he believes in you. And way up in the clouds, he's telling you, money has no value, Jeffrey. The only thing that really matters is love, man.
That's real funny. Now give me my $100 before I get really pissed.
Yo, let me make you a deal. I'll play you a game of b-ball for your $100. If you win, I'll give you $200 right then. But if you lose, we cool.
You'll give me $200 if I win.
You got my word, man.
All right, you're on. But don't even think about not paying me if you lose, because that...
Don't worry, Jeffrey. I'll come by and see you when I get 5 minutes.
Let it crawl.
The waitress hasn't come in yet?
She won't be long. Garrett got the lab results. Shall we go?
All right, let me hang up my coat. I'll be right with you.
Okay. See you in a minute.
So, what do you want to start with?
Were there any prints on the book that was under the table?
Yep, and they matched the ones on the fork and the glass. So it was definitely his book. It looked like a fairly old book. Maybe we can get some more stuff out of it.
What about the pool of blood in the stall?
You're not going to believe this. The blood wasn't from the victim. It was from the killer.
What was he doing bleeding in the stall?
I have absolutely no idea.
What did you find on the knife?
Got some good prints off it. They matched those found on the fork and glass at the suspect's table.
So, the murderer was definitely at that table.
Anything on the blade?
I'm getting to that. We definitely had blood from the victim, but the weird thing is we also found blood from the killer.
Did you find anything on the coffee cup?
The only prints we found belonged to the waitress.
That's impossible, man. That cup was half empty. Somebody must have drank it.
So, what do you think about all that?
I don't have any explanation for the blood in the stall. The victim could have wounded the killer during a struggle, but it doesn't make sense that it would be in the stall. It's as though the killer wounded himself.
Hey, why not? You get clumsy fools in every other profession. Why not killers?
That's kind of a flimsy explanation, Garrett.
To each his own, Carla. I do the testing, you figure out the reason why.
Thanks for your help, Garrett. See you later.
So, what do we do now?
You go take care of the composite. I'm gonna go check with the coroner and see if he got anything from the body.
Okay. Catch you later.